There's a common misconception that for any engine that tends to fill an oil overflow catch can, this must mean that the engine is terminally damaged. Now, while of course there may be some truth in this, we're going to find that every engine naturally will breathe a little bit. This is called blowby, and it's the combustion pressure escaping past the rings, making its way down into the crankcase and then through the breather system into the catch can. Now, this is perfectly natural, and even a freshly built engine will tend to have some level of blowby. What makes this worse is when we're talking about very high boost drag engines, the amount of blowby will naturally increase even if the engine is in perfect health. When any amount of blowby is present, we're also likely to find that the blowby gases will naturally draw oil vapor with them from the crankcase. And this is why we tend to find our oil catch cans do fill up over time with oil. Now, under normal circumstances, this is no problem, and a normal engine bay mounted catch can will adequately counter this. When we're talking about a very high power, high boost drag engine though, a lot more oil vapor will be pulled through, and then there's also the potential for something to fail in the engine, which will involve a lot more oil going through the breather system. Now, potentially, if we're running an engine bay mounted catch can, this could be catastrophic. If the engine does fail, this can result in a lot of oil making its way into the catch can and the catch can overflowing. If any of this oil then makes its way underneath one of the tyres, this could result in the driver losing control of the car. So a novel approach that we can see in the English racing built R35 GTR behind me is that they've actually mounted a catch can in the rear of the car in the boot area. Now this means that all of the breather system needs to make its way through the car, through the cabin, all the way to the back of the car, and this is the large diameter line that you can see making its way into the catch can. So this gathers all of the blowby gases in the rear of the car, and the advantage here is that if there is a failure and the catch can does tend to overflow, all of the oil is rearward of the wheels. This means that there's no chance of oil making its way underneath a tyre. Now, one of the common servicing jobs with this car or any high powered drag car is to drain that oil catch can between runs, and this can be easily achieved with the ball valve that we can see at the bottom of the catch can, and then this goes to a drain at the rear bumper. This makes it really easy for the team to drain any oil out of the catch can, preparing the car for the next run.
If you like that video, make sure you give it a thumbs up, and if you're not already a subscriber, make sure you're subscribed. We release a new video every week. And if you like free stuff, we've got a great deal for you. Click the link in the description to claim your free spot to our next live lesson. You'll learn about performance engine building and EFI tuning, and you'll also have the chance to ask questions which I'll be answering live. Remember, it's 100% free, so follow the link to claim your spot.